Thank you. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, chief guest of this afternoon's program, our Honorable Deputy Chief Minister, Honorable Sahib, Dr. Rosas Sahib, IMRC President, Honorable Sahib, Master Sahib, and to all the invitees, good afternoon, Assalamu alaikum. First, let me congratulate IMRC for the wonderful work that it has done, and many, many congratulations. For the last few months, I have been a direct witness to what they have been doing in India, particularly in Hyderabad. I have visited your schools, the Charities School in the outskirts of the city, the orphanage, wonderful orphanage for girls, and later, where I had a role in starting the Challenger Civil Services Academy. It's slowly becoming a passion for me to go and spend time with the children. I really enjoy doing that. The activities are being done with passion. Your earlier schools are finished and are being well, in fact, I'm waiting for an opportunity to go to Zahirabad to visit your the Institute of Technology. Perhaps it will happen very soon. Among these, the Civil Service Academy had a very interesting genesis. In fact, while you know IMRC, I have not known when it started and then all the anecdotes that you knew through 80s and 90s, what you went through and why you started. The Civil Services Academy of yours had a very interesting birth. Coincidentally, it happened on the day on which I was sitting with the Principal Secretary of Minorities Welfare, Omar Jalil, and a few other IAS officers who had visited me that morning in my office. We were discussing about how to increase the representation of minorities in higher civil services into the decision-making, highest decision-making bodies in the government. That morning, I have gone and visited the Minorities Finance Corporation where we had put a lot of money, we did not know how to disperse it to the needy in the community. Alongside, I went and visited the Minorities Study Center, which was impacting training for the youth to take on the civil services examinations. I was not happy with the quality of students and much less with the faculty. When I adjourned to the office, when these officers come and met me, I told first thing we should design and close down the minority study center. I was telling my colleagues that perhaps we are doing a lot of disservice by keeping that institute on. Neither we are giving the quality coaching, nor enhancing the chances of getting any success at the civil service. We may say that we are doing it free of cost, but that is not what the youth intended. They won't mind spending some money, provided they get good quality help. It was not happening. That's why ultimately, we met the honorable Chief Minister, and I was one of the two strongest veterans I know civil services. I am in it. My son has taken civil services examination. I know what it takes. Anyway, my views are a little different from Dr. Rosa's views on civil services, why we should get into civil services in preference to other careers. But I'll come to a little later. But then, we decide. That's the day Anish Bhai came and met me on behalf of IMRC. Initially, I thought it was a passing fancy. Because many have approached from Bangalore and other places, that we want to do something for the youth. We want more representation in civil services. And every time, I think that they think that it's too easy, they don't know what it takes to get into civil services. And then the idea also wasn't really carried forward any further. But here, three times, four times, he kept meeting me. Then I understood that he really means that it should get started. That's the time I got involved with it. I told him, unless you have patience, you are willing to commit resources, and get rest of the faculty and rest of the residential facility for the students, and also take 50, 60 high quality youth and train them. That is for 2 years, you may not address your objective. We got into civil service in the 80s. Me, Dr. Oscar, all of us belong to actually the vintage model now, in the 1980s. Civil service recognition has undergone a lot of change. To give you a glimpse, an idea, last year, the total number of applicants were 9.63 lakhs. Slightly less than 1 million. You know how many jobs were offered? Slightly upwards of 1,000. That is the ratio. And then, so many filtration stages. First, out of these 9.63 lakhs, of course, 20-30% don't take the first examination, the preliminary examination. Out of that, the filter will take close to 15,000 serious candidates. Out of those 15,000, you take another main examination, which is a very, very rigorous, a grueling examination. 2 years, 3 years, they dedicate their lives and then the brightness of the youth. And then they take this exam. Out of this, close to 3,000 are taken for the interview. And finally, 1,000 are selected for that. Those are the ratios. If anybody gets better in the numbers and the percentage of the chance one has to get into, they should not come anywhere near to their sense. Neither from the side where they want to help the students, nor from the side of the candidate themselves. This is one thing I made absolutely clear on that day. That is why you have to pick up right and high quality youth, give them excellent facilities, mentor them, and then allow them to compete year after year. At least you have to go through 3 or 4 years before you have a realistic chance of making it. When I said all this, you know, India and I are telling you, we are willing to do what we should do this. Why did we do civil services at all? Yes, compared to the early 80s, when we had very few careers on offer to us. We could get into banks, we could become engineer or a doctor or civil services. These are only 4 or 5 of the very few careers that we had at the time. In fact, when we came out of the college, civil service was not on our mind. I got a fellowship to Harvard, I was to come. That year I took the exam, but once I got in, I stayed back. This year was 1978. But then, why get into civil services now compared to earlier times? It is a big question. One is, the representation of minorities in civil services is very, very low. But 12-14% of the population from Muslims that you have in India, 1.3% is the representation in the civil services. Government has enormous resources. This year, for instance, the government of India budget is close to 20 lakh crores. And it makes the policies. It has the authority to make those policies, to implement them. It's a huge organization, millions and millions of government servants. You may do well as doctors, industrialists, but you can't match these resources that are available in the hands of the civil servants that belong to the government. If you have to stake a claim out of this pie, your share, you have to be in decision-making levels. Then only you can do something for yourself and something for your community. Otherwise, the community continues to suffer. That is the sole and most important reason as to why you should cooperate with most of you, those who have the ability to get into this. One way you can look at your 9.60 lakhs, only 1,000 for whether you can stand a chance. On the other side, if you see the 1,000, only 30-40 of the youth are getting in front of them. If you really help them, the number will go up to 100, 110, 150 if you mentor the community. So that is the effort that has started. I have seen, for instance, the 100 facility in Delhi. Very recently, I have gone to Pune. There I saw another study session. We started doing this maybe a decade or two earlier. Today the results are very good. Hyderabad used to have a good representation in civil services. But of late, the last 2 years or so, it has dwindled so badly that now in the IPS, when I look down, I don't think there's any other boy who's there in the MS service. I'm 36 years old in service now. There are not even one boy who has made it to the IPS. I am there, a couple of them. One or two who are coming from other states, from the minorities. Otherwise, we don't have anybody. So that is the historical picture. That's why we have to work hard on our youth and put them into the civil services so that they are able to assist many capacities. What are those who attend the civil services ultimately don't make it? They can make to the banking sector, the higher levels, and to many other areas where still there is a message to make it. What is the access to Muslims, entrepreneurs for instance, to the loan from the bank? It's only 1%, the 12% population. When you come to work, the number of bank accounts, etc., is 89%. But loan availment for the entrepreneurs, it is not even 1%. So if you have to correct this picture, you have to get into areas where resources exist, public finances exist, power and authority exist, where organizations, government organizations exist. No amount of private effort is going to compensate for the need to get into service. But to get in there is really difficult, but we have to get in there. It takes time, it takes a lot of patience. There is a particular species of Chinese bank. The Chinese farmers laboriously cut them and they get dried up very soon. They look very yellowish. Ultimately, they want to plant and start watering it. Months and months will be watering it, there is no sign of life. But those farmers do not believe that. They keep on watering for 3 years, 4 years. Slowly, start seeing signs of life and start turning green. Thereafter, the speed within the growth, you can literally see it grow. The beginning by a few feet it keeps growing. That is exactly what will happen when you are any investment you are making in civil services. A couple of years you have worked hard, the third year, the fourth year, then you have to start getting the results. I went to address the academic boards very recently in Hyderabad. In fact, we invited an informal atmosphere. I went to play a cricket with them, and then went to the girls' area, girls' hostel, and shuttle with them. Shuttle is a very recent fire in India, particularly in Hyderabad, since the Hyderabad girl won the silver. So, under the train, and then we all sat down and discussed this. Your initial kick, Manzoor Bhai, I can tell you, your initial kick of 40-50 children that you have done is very good. And if you nurture them for 2 years, you will definitely start getting results. You have to plant one officer first from your academy into the services. That is going to be a demonstrative effect. That is going to be the results. I'm sure that you will do it. And this effort will depend on the success. You owe it to the government to put more and more people into civil service. The other one, only money in your head, perhaps you have to pray. Three of your children, none of them are taking this place in civil service, where you are out of the country for very long. And if you find a lot of police children who have come to stage, they are getting back after 2-3 years, and are doing a lot of things here, and again coming back and taking civil service. I have a very interesting experience in my school. My first time really is earlier from here, from USA. And then worked for 3-4 years. He came back, of course, he did not want to be in service. He is an entrepreneur, he is doing in his own way as well as he can. The second son, he did from this Kurani, his engineering. When we sat down and discussed with him career options. He wanted to stay back and do sales. Last year, fortunately, he got him. But then, now, whether it be me or the way we look at this, compared to the time when we had been in the services, now the check back is decent, his social life, very secure life, and and the career opportunities. Government government has opened up quite a lot. India has really become prosperous now. It also wants to attract a lot of talent into civil services. It is allowing you to, 4 years, 5 years, you will go out, come, study here, work in private sector, very qualified into government sector. Many of my colleagues, the junior colleagues who are SPs and AIGs, they have all come to help these places and studied at Harvard, Stanford, and they can provide more services. Some of them work for 10, 15, 20 years and then try to do something on their own. All this is happening. So, civil services, I think, is still a good career option. Last year, there was one boy, my family, I can tell you, one boy named Karo Adavani. This boy, he joined IQS. He met me, he wanted to take the exam again. He met me, and then I asked him his background. He was working in City Bank in Hong Kong at a graduate of 1.6% degrees a year. When he wanted to take civil, I first told him, look, you are not going to get 5% of what you are getting now when you get into civil. But he said, no sir, still I want to compete and do. We worked together with each other for some time. I knew that he would be in the top 50, 60. He ended up competing in the whole country. And Indian civil service examination is supposed to be the toughest civil service examination on earth. But then, you have to accept this challenge and then do it. With all of the problem that we keep seeing in many of the engineering and medical colleges, you know, in the USA, many of them don't take a vision plan very easy. Once they are there in the engineering and medical colleges, all that they want to do is go to work in Sarona. Is there a life that's taken care of there? They don't have that vision, parents also don't push them in that. I have seen in Middle East also, many of the youngsters, they're meritorious youngsters. They can write the examination and get into government medical colleges, PCs, and it's impossible to get it. But the parents still have an insurance seat for them by paying 60, 70, 80 lakhs in medical colleges and put them there in those private medical colleges where you don't have facilities here. It's a problem of vision, problem of mentoring, parents not telling them that you are on your own and you should be able to succeed with only if you work hard. That is not happening. So, in this case, it is something like, oh, my life is under the pressure of the hotel and the and you expect to win all the way. First, you have to enter the arena of war and then to back it off. If you don't do it, whatever little chance of success that you have, then you are going to take the rest. I think enough of civil services, because I think now the atmosphere is a civil service challenge, civil service academy, and the party, what I was also mentioned, I thought I would respond to this. The second area, I have a small presentation, I rushed through this presentation. And this I thought is important. I thought it's important because whatever we do for our youth today and for the community today, if we have the single one area, as your our anybody's contribution, our generation's contribution, that has to be the area of education. All of you here in the university are only because of your education, nothing else. Nothing else. So if you have to change your role, change the future of the community, it is here that you have to invest. I think you should start doing it from here. We're talking of empowering these minorities. Anywhere in the world and in our country, the minority, the biggest single minority that we have is the Muslims. In one of the three, you have to succeed, you have to have education, you have to control financial resources, or in a democracy, you have to say politically, have a say. If you don't have any of these, it's very, very difficult to do. If you have to look at the status of education in India, vis-a-vis the minorities, so this is it. This country definitely has progressed. In 1950s, it was slightly upwards of 20%. Now, it is down to 80% education. Literacy rates, community-wide, you see. Yes, Muslims also progressed to other communities. But the commensurate growth in our community is not as much as in other communities, like Hindus or other minority communities.